Hi.
Hi, I'm Jade.
Hi, I'm Evelyn.
Welcome to this week's edition of the Wolfpack Weekly News Program.
Good morning, fellow wolves, and happy Friday to you.
Yes, indeed, and we hope that everyone has had a great start to their day.
Just a reminder to all of our fellow wolves, Monday there is no school as it is a federal holiday.
That is right. It is Memorial Day, which is a day on which those who died in active military service are remembered.
Yes, and before we move on, we would like to say to any of our fellow wolves out there who now have or once had a family member serving in the military, their service is very much appreciated. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that life to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Thank you, fellow wolves, for taking a moment with us. And now we have a loaded broadcast for you this week, so we need to jump right in.
Let's check it out.
On Saturday, May 19th, 124 of our 8th grade wolves headed up to Buena Park for their annual end of the year Knott's field trip.
Thank you, Mr. Alvarez, Ms. Amaya, Ms. Carlos, Mr. Nunez, Ms. Norton, Mr. Dawson, Ms. Gomez, and Mr. Ozer for giving time over the weekend to chaperone the trip.
Let's check it out. Having a good time, having a good time. I'm a shooting star leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car passing by.
For 8th graders. What a fun and memorable day.
Hey, Mason, speaking of fun and memorable, there have been many events, activities, clubs, and classes that have been pretty fun and memorable this year. For example, this broadcast class.
That's right, Josh. I will definitely remember this class and having the opportunity to highlight all the amazing things that go on here at our school.
I know, right? And it was also fun to be able to be silly, creative, and show our unique personalities.
That's for sure. It was definitely fun filming all these segments, but sometimes it took forever.
Right? It seems like it would just be easy to just sit there and read something, but it's not as easy as it looks. Sometimes it took forever to tape even a 45-second intro. For example, this is our 12th try.
I know, and we would have to tape something over and over and over again.
Hey, I think we should show our fellow wolves what we are talking about.
Great idea! Let's check it out!
Zeta.
And I'm Lily.
Welcome to this week's edition of the Wolfpack Weekly News Program.
The winter was an all-star.
Stop. Winner.
The winner.
Winner of
the winter.
Winter.
But I might
do
this when I have time and I gotta finish.
Grand
it's
not even. I don't like
Wait, straight it back.
Close them?
No.
Oh!
Wait, no,
okay. Go.
Where's Mel?
And Daddy Tanner.
And Rebecca Donaldson.
And me.
And we have four guests.
Can I have a banana since you took my chocolate that one day?
No. Can I have a banana?
Assistance of three other amazing LGA staff members. Let's check it out.
Right through them.
Hey, thinking.
Oh my God.
You got it?
Hey,
start.
No. In
the intro.
Okay. The eighth grade students and Mrs.
Okay. Hi, I'm Yasha.
Hold on.
For Black History Month, in which they had chose and which they each chose, right?
Two,
two, three, four. Wait, you gotta go.
Wow, those jokers are as funny as ever.
That was fun. I love watching bloopers. You know, like when they play them at the end of a movie.
I know, they're always so funny.
Hey, speaking of funny, are you ready to keep the laughter going?
I sure am. Is it time for our jokers?
Yep.
Let's check it out.
Hi, I'm Lily.
And I'm Mason.
And I'm Abby.
And we're the Wolfpack Jokers.
What kind of dance did Lightning McQueen and Mater perform in the talent show?
What?
Break dance.
Why did the mushroom decide to tell jokes in the talent show?
Why?
Because he was a fun guy.
Why did Johnny keep his guitar in the refrigerator right before the talent show?
Why?
Why?
So he can play Comey, isn't
it? Why wasn't the soprano singer allowed to sing in the talent show?
Why?
Because she got in trouble.
What do you call a singing vegetable?
What?
Elvis Parsley.
Hey! Why did that kid in the talent show keep banging his head on the piano keys?
Why?
He was trying to play by ear. Bye!
Those were some funny talent show jokes, and our jokers were quite talented in their delivery of them.
That's for sure. It seems like we have many talented wolves here at LGA. In fact, if you attended the talent show, you could have witnessed this for yourself.
Bummer, I couldn't make it.
Well, that's okay. Our Wolfpack weekly news crew got some footage from last Wednesday's fun and exciting evening.
Let's check it out. What's going on? What's going on? Yeah, what's going
on? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? On Wednesday, May 23rd at 6 p.m., LGA Middle held its annual talent show.
This year's talent show was made possible with the guidance and assistance of the following staff: Mr. Brazell and Ms. Harris, Mr. Nunez, Ms. Vasquez, and Mr. K.
Also, a huge thank you to our MCs, Anna Nguyen and Elizabeth Thornton, and our backstage helpers, Seda Valdez, Efrain Duarte, and Yusbury Martinez.
And a big, big shout out to all of the amazing students who participated and shared their amazing talents with all of us.
Here are the students who performed.
The
Let's check it out. Take my laptop, record a snapshot, and change your point of view.
So much talent in our school.
That is correct, Zeta. In fact, up next we have 13 individuals who are recognized by the staff here at LGA for their individual talents.
Let's check it out.
On Thursday, May 17th, six of our fellow Wolves were recognized at the 2018 Touching the Spirit Annual Student Award Assembly. This special event is hosted by the AAAE, which is a San Diego County Association of African American Educators. These students from LGA were nominated for the awards.
The Academic Achievement Award went to John A. Maxey and Ernest Alexander.
Karis Jordan and Jalil Tucker received the Community Service Award.
And the Pride and Culture Heritage Award went to Nia Lumpkin and Nijay Carter.
On Tuesday, May 22nd, our district held their annual Celebrating Student Success Awards program for students in kindergarten through 8th grade.
Raquia Hussein and Gary George were recognized for their academic growth this school year, and Coralyn Sabal and Analia Benuelos were recognized for citizenship.
That evening, three students were also recognized in the Robert Carroll 8th grade history essay competition.
Anna Nguyen received second place, Evelyn Martinez received third place, and Caitlin Howard received honorable mention.
Great job to all these students. Now let's give them all a howl. One, two, three.
It is so great to see that so many of our fellow Wolves are dedicated to learning and strive to set examples for others and do well in school.
That's right, Zeta. Congratulations to these 13 amazing students.
Yes, and before we go, we have one final group of amazing students that we would like to highlight in this week's broadcast. Let's check it out.
Up next, we would like to share with you some pictures and videos from the Pops concert at Mount Miguel last Friday.
That's right, our LGA band students got to play in the concert with Mount Miguel band students as well as Mount Miguel alumni.
Yes, and the concert included music from Cars as well as both Star Trek and Pixar medleys.
Thank you so much, Mr. Ahrens, and our band students for all the extra time and practice you put into this event.
Let's check it out.
We'll be right back.
Have a great 3-day weekend.
Bye.
Larry.